cotton clothes in summer season. Very correct. So this is a cotton cloth. Correct. Now we have another material. This is wool, right? This is a gloves and this is a woolen material. We have also talked about the fibers, yarns and fabric. Isn't it? So fibers we know are a single thinnest thread. Then when these threads are twisted together, then it forms yarn. And when these yarns are multiply weaved together, they form fabric. So this we have studied. And we have also talked about the types of fiber, right? So how many types of fibers are there? There are two types of fibers. What are they? That is natural fiber and we have artificial or synthetic fiber. Correct? So take it from plants. Tattoos, again, we take it from plants. But if we are preparing certain milk item, so that we will get from animal, right? Milk, we get it from animal, correct? Egg, again, we obtain it from animal, correct? So there are different ingredients that we obtain from different plants and animals, clear? So what are the main sources and from where we get these ingredients? We get these ingredients either from plant or from animals. Correct?
Utkarsh, what are potential resources?
Sir, the resources of which we do not know the actual quantity.
Very good. If total available quantity is not known, those are potential resources. Very good, Utkarsh. Please mute yourself. And another question is, if we have to classify natural resources on the basis of renewability, then many are raising their hand. Nilab Upadhyay. Nilab, beta, give your answer.
Renewable and non-renewable resources.
Renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Very good. If we have to classify natural resources on the basis of distribution, to Arpita. Arpita, beta, please unmute yourself and please give the answer. Arpita.
So ubiquitous and localized.
That is ubiquitous and localized. So what are ubiquitous resources? Last question it is, what are ubiquitous resources?
The resources that are found everywhere.
Okay, resources which are found everywhere. Like solar energy and wind energy.
It is having 5 equal parts. So out of that parts, 3 if you have taken, then it is the what? It will be the numerator. Okay, see the example. Total 5 blocks are there and there are 3 shaded blocks. Out of total 5 blocks, 3 were shaded. Now next. What is the numerator and what is the denominator? See with the example, we are having one circle and this circle is divided into 5 equal parts. The circle is represented as whole and in that there are 5 parts. Two parts were shaded, so it is called as 2/5. Proper fraction. Now let's talk about types of fraction. Proper fraction, you are having 5 types of fraction in your book. Apart from that, there are, if we say that a numerator, if the numerator in a fraction, if the numerator is smaller than the denominator, then it is called as proper fraction.
You have completed that question also. Question number three
is -11. Let me maximize it. -11 +12, then minus, and in a bracket -10.
Right. What comes in between? Here we need to write the number, right? Here we are going to write the number. You can see there is number 1 written and number 3 written. And that's a box. Here we have to write the answer. So which number is going to come in between 1 and 3? Yes? Which number is going to come in between 1 and 3? Yes, Shreyanshi, say it. Harshit, say it. Yes, 2. I got the answer from Shreyanshi. So number 2 is going to come in between the number 1 and 3. Everyone, so now make it. Use pencil for making the box. We are going to put these digits in this box. Okay, so from where we will start? From this ones place. Now, 0 is at the ones place, so we will write here 0. Now, I'm writing here 0. Next, in the tens place, there is 9. Then in 100 place, you can see there is 7. So, always start from the ones place so that you will not make mistakes. So, we have written 790. Now, we have 5 at the 1000 place. Then we have 9 at the 1000 place, 10,000 place. Then we have 8 in the lakh place. And again, we have 8 in the 10 lakh place.
Even that, so why the interest on capital here is decreasing the capital, because person have to return the extra. What the person had already charged extra 2%, now the person have to return. And when person is returning the interest on capital, capital is decreased, so capital will be debit. Capital will be debit. And this 4,800 will be divided in 4,800 profit will be divided in which ratio, bacha? So no ratio is given in the question. So it will be 1:1:1. And profit will increase or decrease? So sir, profit will increase.